Ladies and gentlemen, we are live, Glad Rap Channel, here for what tonight is called Peach Boxing The Rising. We've got a lot of Irish followers tonight, in conjunction with a lot of Kiwis. First up, we've got So for the first bout, we've got Barry, the Pump Powell, fighting out of Ireland. He's standing at 5'11", 90 kilograms, 29 years old. He's playing out of the club Maris. Next up, Porrick, the Traveller Meany, coming out of the red corner, also fighting out of Ireland. His area is Kilkenny, sitting at 6'1", 85 kilograms. He's only 24 years old. A lot of guys tonight are getting in for the first time. So look, we are looking for obviously a bit more heart over technical boxing tonight, but it is going to be an absolute banger.
Tonight's tournament is sanctioned by the New Zealand National Boxing Federation. Officials at ringside are referee Jeff Nelson. The judges for tonight's first round, Steve Mills, Lorraine Glacier, and Lou Ross. Thank you, Ashma. And thank you for tonight, Gary Watts. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the fighters. First up, Commonwealth Sports. He's 29 years of age, weighing in at 90 kgs. Ladies and gentlemen, he plays for the Maris Club. Put your hands together, please, for Barry Pump Powell. There's a moment tonight, the traveller from Mixed Peach Boxing from Kilkenny in Ireland. He's 6'1", 85 kilograms, 24 years of age, ladies and gentlemen. And plays his game of football in the mighty Waikato. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, please, for Porrick, the Traveller
Meany. Can you also make instructions in the dressing room? Aim your plans at all times. Protect yourself at all times. This is the bottom line.
Now, in most cases, you'd look at a fight card and see, a country versus another country. These guys are both from Ireland. They play for different clubs, but they've brought a bit of culture over to New Zealand. So let's see how they go tonight in their first round bout. Poro coming out quite aggressive, good guard, but Barry. Nice tight guard there from Porrick. He's looking quite composed and comfortable for a first time fight. Barry, on the other hand, is just going for gold. He doesn't want to go to the third round tonight from the looks at this start of the round. Another looping overhand right there, just went nowhere. But as they say, and I might say this often tonight, you got to risk it to get the biscuit. And with any shots that Barry is throwing, one hit can make all the difference. So he's just coming forward, charging, love it. I'm sure the crowd's loving it tonight too. We've got a full ABA house tonight. Barry doing quite well to stay under the guard of Porrick. Missing with the overhand right, then Barry came in with that straight right that clipped Porrick there, just right on the top of the head. And again, uppercut. right. Like I said, folks, sometimes that aggressive style can come through and does do the damage. It's only probably about halfway through the first round. There you have it, round one. Out. As you can see, Peachy obviously some words of advice and wisdom right there. Here we go, round two. First time fighters, you've got to give it up. Obviously they're not going to be too technical, but what they lack in that technical aspect will come through via aggression and pure basically pure aggression and will to win in front of their home crowd and their supporters tonight. Still both of them holding their hands very, very high, which is good. Reasonably tight guard. Barry in the blues, slightly dropping, with Porrett coming through to straight rights. Porrett doing well, he's moving around. And those angles reasonably well for a first-time fighter. Barry, on the other hand, is just an aggressive mongrel coming forward. Does not want to go the distance, but both these two looking a little bit more tired than the first round, but they're pushing forward. They're showing heart, but this is boxing. This is boxing. You train 3 to 4 weeks, hard, intense, 5 times a week, 6 times, 7 times, for 6 minutes in the ring. And a lot of things go out the window, like they are right now. Barry, if there was awards or points given for aggression and walk forward style, he would win. But right now, he's coming forward even more. 10 second clapper. Who's going to finish the round strong? Is it going to be Barry or Porrett? I'm glad I'm not one of the judges tonight, because I'd have my work cut out for me. Depends what the judges are looking for tonight. They'll either be looking for clean shots, aggression, and where the shots are landing. And that's why I challenge you guys viewing at home to say who's winning this fight, because I can't call it. Barry, in traditional style, coming forward, leaving nothing for the road home. He's chasing him. Porrett looks like he's obviously slipping in and out, running away, but Barry is in for the kill. Like I said, I love aggression, and Barry is coming forward. If I judge for aggression, he'd be winning my books. Oh, a bit of a push. Porrett beautiful overhand right there. Another one, it was an overhand hook. He's coming forward. He may not be technical, but he has got aggression. He's got the heart, he's coming forward. He's bringing this. Close up there, two shots miss. Barrett is walking forward like the Terminator. Doesn't give a star. These boys are gas. They probably haven't done anything like this before. Most soccer fight matches last about 15 seconds. This one's gone for 6 minutes. Turning away, breathing heavy. You can just tell they're both gassed, but they're going for it. He's still continuing to throw forward and push forward. Very powerful. The heart on this man is just incredible. 10-second clapper. Barry just pushing forward. Uppercuts. Well, the pump pal certainly lived up to his name. He pumped the Traveller the whole way through every single round. In my books, and unofficially, Barry has got the win on this one, but Porrick came to party, and he was using his reach very, very nicely.
Thank you.